good morning, and welcome to your Monday morning yoga minutes. I'm Audra Monk, and I teach at Mountain Spirit Yoga in Middletown, Maryland. And we would love for you to come join us there for our class or our workshop. So check out our website, mountainspirityoga.com, and come and join us soon. So today, at home or wherever you are, we're going to do some gentle yoga for the low back and the hips. So you want to come on down to the floor really carefully, and you could do this in your bed. You could do this laying on the carpet, or you could do it, of course, on your yoga mat. So come on down nice and careful, and we're going to come all the way to our backs. Take your time. If you need a little padding, I wouldn't get a big pillow, but a very, like a blanket or a towel, that would be fine. Oops, and let me bring my blocks over closer, because we might use these in a little bit. Okay, so there we go. So come on down. And have your knees bent, and just take a moment and find the earth beneath you. So you might need to rock a little, you know, you might need to stretch a moment, and then find the place that's most comfortable for you. So I'm going to go with bent knees. You could also, at this very beginning part, go with straight legs. That is fine too, if your back is happy with that. But I'm going to keep it really gentle today. All right, next, make sure your shoulders are comfortable, and your head is comfortable on the floor. All right, pick a leg, any leg you want, and you're going to hug that knee in. And you might hold on to the knee, or you might hold behind the thigh, whatever feels right for you. Double check that the low back is comfortable. All right, and now we're going to start to take this knee in and out. So on an inhale, have your arms go to straight, the knee goes away. Exhale, hug it back in, and just keep the lower leg relaxed. And let's repeat, inhale, take it away. Exhale, hug it in. Good. And we will repeat this. If you want a little bit more to think about as you move, maybe think about that when you inhale from the pelvic floor, you zip up through the belly button inside, and as you exhale, you let that soften. Good. And the knee is just coming in and out. Good. The head and the shoulders are relaxed. All right. The next time you bring the knee in, we're going to hold that knee in. You might hug it a lot. Some people like a real snug hug here. Some people like it in the middle. Some people like it really loose. All are totally fine. Listen to your back and do what feels right for today. And then let your arms rest heavy, let your head rest heavy, and go ahead and now just move your foot around. Good. So this is really nice and gentle. I usually do this practice before I get out of bed in the morning. It just keeps my back and my hips super happy. Good. Wiggle your toes a little. All right, and then relax your foot and gently set that foot on the floor. Good. Pause for just a moment and let's switch sides. So hug your other knee in. And again, you can hold behind the thigh. You can hold on the knee, wherever it feels right for you. And then when you're ready, start to take this in and out. On your inhale, take your arms to straight. On your exhale, hug them in. Hi, puppy. And let that repeat. So the knee goes away, the belly pulls in. The exhale, the knee comes back in. Hi, dog. Scooch over. There we go. And we let that repeat. Good. Maybe thinking about on that inhale that we inhale, pulling the belly in from deep inside. Okay, the next time we hug the knee in, we're going to keep it in. So pull it in, and again, you might want it really snug, you might want it medium, you might want it far away. Wherever that is for you is just fine. Hug it in, relax your arms, relax your shoulders, relax your head. Good. And then move your foot around, circle it one way, and circle it the other way. Scooch out of the way, sweetie. There you go. Good. Just move it where it feels right for you. All right, and then gently release. Okay, give it a breath, and then we're moving on. We're going to go back to the first leg, and now we're going to open and close the knee. So when you're ready, take your leg towards straight and bend it back in. Good. So opening the knee and closing the knee, and this could be the inhale as you extend and the exhale as you soften. Good. Nice and easy. When that leg goes up, you know, try to get it nice and, you know, evened up, but move within a comfortable range of motion. All right, and then keep it up there just a moment. And now we're going to bend this knee and place your ankle on the other leg, which I didn't tell you to bend that knee. So if that leg was straight, go ahead and bend it up. Okay, pup, stop. All right, so we might stay here for our figure four stretch. You might want to lift the foot off the floor, or you might want to hug the knees into the chest. Any of those choices are fine, and you might hug it in for a moment and then set it back down. Totally up to you. I'm having dog problems today. All right, so let yourself breathe here, wherever this is. And this is super great for the hips. If you have some sciatica, usually this will help relieve that pressure on that nerve. If you've been sitting or standing a lot, this is a really great stretch to just add to your everyday. Okay, so we're going to release it because there's one last part today. We're going to take a twist. So if your right leg is the one that is crossed over, you're going to take the knees to the right. So whatever the cross leg is, that's the side you're going to. All right, so if you go to the side and you decide that's too much stretch for today, take a blanket or a block or a pillow and put it under that outside knee. Good. If it feels okay, of course, take it all the way there. All right, and then the last part. So you could leave your hands resting here on the ribs and keep this a little bit soft. If the shoulders are feeling pretty good today, maybe we're going to multitask a little and add a stretch. So we can bring the hands towards the ceiling and then fold at the elbows and then maybe you rest the forearms on your forehead. Or maybe they go up and over and you rest them on the floor. And it is totally okay if that back shoulder is not on the floor. My back shoulder is not on the floor right now. And I am okay with that. But do I feel a glorious stretch down this whole top side? Yes, I do. I'm going to enjoy it for one more deep breath here. All right, and then first I'm going to release the arms. I'm going to bring them up. Take them back up towards the ceiling, and then let them melt down. And then if I need my hands, I'm going to use my hands to help the legs back to center. But if they'll just come on back, I can bring them back. And then I'm going to uncross the leg, double check that I get the hips and the shoulders re-even, and I'm going to pause. All right, so all we have to do is the other side, and we'll be done with our practice today. So bring in your opposite leg. All right, so remember, we have to open and close the knee. So take the foot towards the ceiling. And bend it back down. And repeat, foot towards the ceiling. And bring it back in. So that's the inhale where we extend. And the exhale where we bend. Good job. And let it repeat nice and easy. Leg going as straight as yours will go today. Good. And then if the other leg is not bent, go ahead and bend it up. And then set this ankle on that knee. Let that knee kind of press out. Good. And we might just relax here. Maybe I'm relaxing here, but I'm getting plenty of stretch in my hip and my leg. I'm getting a nice little bit. Good. If I'm looking for more, maybe I lift the foot off the floor. And I might lift it off and then just put it back down. And I could repeat that, or I could lift it off and stay. Or maybe I can bring it a little closer and reach those hands around and through. Actually, I guess through and around. And I can hold on here. And I have a gentle flex in the foot. Not too much, but nice and gentle. Good. And I can pause and breathe here. Good. And take one more breath here. All right. If you've got the foot up, set it gently down. Keep the leg crossed. And now that twist. So whatever leg. So I have my left leg. But whatever leg it is, you go towards that side. And I'm just going to twist and let that thigh come on down. Knowing that if it's uncomfortable, I can add a block or a blanket or a pillow under that thigh. So finding the place that's right for me. I could keep my hands soft and relaxed on my ribs. Or I could add that little shoulder stretch. Bring the arms up towards the ceiling. Okay, now this is kind of funny. So there's a way you normally cross your arms. And you probably did that the first time. Uncross them and do them your kind of your wonky way, your opposite way. And then maybe I just rest the forearms on my forehead. Or maybe I take them up and over and I rest them on the floor above my head. You could change your mind and bring them back. Good.
And then we're going to breathe a couple big breaths. And if you can direct that breath into this top side, you're really going to enjoy it. And one more breath here. Okay, we're going to take the arms out first. So bring the arms back. Bring them up towards the ceiling. Good. Let them melt on down. And that way, if we need our hands to help, we can use them. But we're going to bring those knees back to center and uncross. Okay, so if you've done any yoga videos with me before, you might know this, that if we go asymmetrical, it's very nice to go symmetrical to end. So we're just going to hug both knees in today. You could, of course, go find another video. I think happy baby pose would go great after this. You could roll up and do some cat and cow poses or child's pose to table pose. So many options. But I like to keep these short. And so we're just about 10 minutes here, maybe a teeny bit more. Maybe take these knees in and out. But sometimes it's nice just to know that you can do 10 minutes of gentle yoga and your body will be thankful for you all day. All right, gently release the feet to the floor. A 10-second Shavasana. Rest the arms, rest the eyes, and breathe. Feel free to stay here longer. Totally fine. Just click stop, rest, and breathe, and you're good to go. Or very gently roll to one side or the other, help yourself up, and off you can go about your day. Thank you so very much for joining me for a little bit of yoga. I'm so appreciative. Give me a like or a love. Let us know that you're watching. We really appreciate it. Thank you, and namaste.